Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about brightness. We all heard that term. Don't know about a definition of it, but we sure know how it feels. You know, it's that harsh, brittle, bite, grating kind of sound. You know, it's an excess of frequency and amplitude with, you know, which automatically destroys tonal balance. But it's in a certain frequency range, you know. Let's take a guitar break, for example. Electric guitar is a favorite instrument of mine, and I watch it constantly on the RTA when I watch different artists play. And it seems to be that for guitar, it's 250 to 2.5K seems to be the range that the electrics work in pretty well. So we want to focus, if we're going to go after that frequency range, we always want to focus one more octave below the problem. There's reasons for that. We'll talk about them in another video. But so we want to be able to absorb, and here's the key. And this is what we found a lot of people don't get right. You got to get a lot of that range to make a big difference and get rid of all those harsh and bitter stuff. So it requires treatment that's going to have a depth of 6 to 8 inches. And you know, the reverb times in the room contribute to brightness too. So we got a frequency range that is the brightness, and then we got a room that contributes to that problematic frequency range that we're trying to treat and deal with. So it's a tough deal. Reverb times must be balanced throughout the room. They have to be. So we at least have a fighting chance of dealing with this problem. Now, take a look at this picture here. This is an auditorium that we got asked to do some work on. And you can see here that, you know, they've put a lot of panels up. And, of course, my first question to them is, well, why are you calling us? It doesn't work. And then look at the thickness of the panel. It's 1 inch, 2 at the most. Neither one will do the job. So they had good instincts. They covered a lot of surface area with the wrong technology. So they wasted money. This happens all the time. Happens all the time. They take cost over performance, but they don't know. And these companies just sell them this because they know they're never going to buy from them again. It's a one-shot deal. They don't even try to get it right. So, but if you're in that business and you're considering about treating a larger room, remember that 35, 50 to 65% surface area coverage, that's what we found over the last 18 years in doing large rooms. You got to get 75% of a certain frequency range. And you can't do it with 1 or 2 inch deep panels. So, brightness is a problem. And you got to know how to go after it, and that's the key. And you got to be able to deal with minimizing those qualities. Some of the electronics, the speakers, the delivery systems, you can get horns. Can be a little bright sometimes. We have horns here in the studio. They can be bright, especially at certain frequency ranges. And that's, you know, in the design of the horn. There's not much you can do about it. There is no perfect speaker. You know, there's some that you prefer over others, but there's no such thing as a perfect speaker. To me, the speaker's still the weakest link in the whole chain that we have to deal with in reproducing music. So, brightness. Hope this helps. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.